Here I'm going to be covering Reflect's core AI features, our AI assistant, and the ability to chat with your notes using AI. Now, technically, the voice transcribers that I covered in my last video is also done with AI, but since I covered that, I'm not going to include it here, and I think this is more what people tend to think of when they think of AI note-taking. So I'm going to cover each of these features and then go over some examples. So let me start with the AI assistant. I'm going to start with showing you how to run and use prompts. So I've got a couple examples here that I can run, and all of these are fake examples. I just made the transcripts with ChatGPT, so these are just kind of fake transcriptions, but they're pretty close to what mine actually look like in my notes. These are three of my most common use cases. So first here, I have a call transcript, and I've instructed it to make a fake conversation as if it's some sort of client call. Maybe you're like an agency or a freelancer or something. And this is a transcript from the call. It has everything included. It's not split out. So it's a little bit useless. You can kind of read through it and skim it if you want. But really what you need is it organized into something. So for this, I can just select this here. I'm going to pull up the AI assistant. I just used Command J, but you could also highlight it and click the magic stars here. And then we could have run any number of prompts on it. So maybe I want to run key takeaways and action items. That's a good one for a meeting. So this is a custom prompt that I've created, and it will take the text and just split everything out into key takeaways and action items. So if I just insert this text here, you can see this section below is now the result. I missed the first letter there. There we go. So it just cleanly puts these into each categories. But maybe this is an actual client that I'm talking to, or a potential client. I can have one that actually just runs a project proposal. And I have the format in there. And so it's just going to put out this markdown format as the end result. Again, I'm just going to insert it there. And you can see this kind of hypothetical project proposal where I can go in and fill any of the missing pieces of information. So there's a lot of things you can do with call transcripts. That's a really big use case. The next one here, a daily reflection. So this one's more of a solo one. Let's say I have a daily reflection that I like to do, and that is actually true. I have one that I like. It involves gratitude journaling, you know, like a top priority for the day and affirmations, stuff like that. So this is usually something that I would do while maybe walking around outside in the morning, maybe while making coffee. And this final transcript here is just whatever I would end up with after recording the audio note. So if I select that, again, Command J to the AI assistant, and type in daily reflection, you see I have a custom prompt here that formats it into a daily reflection. So this one, maybe I'm just going to replace it. So I'm going to click replace. And now I have this nice daily reflection with a note pre-backlinked. And it's pretty nice. In this note here, you'll see that I have kind of the standard formatting for my daily reflection. And then here I can put the results. Last one for the example here is an action list. So again, this is a voice note that a fake voice note that I created with ChatGPT for. And so if I just wanted this as listing action items, you know, like very simple for a to-do day, you can just go talk about your to-do list while you're making coffee or something. And then there you go. It's all done. So those are all pretty good examples, but you probably noticed that the standard workflow to use here with the AI assistant is oftentimes on a voice transcription. Now, it certainly doesn't have to be. You can run the AI assistant on any text in your notes you want. So I could, you know, even write a quick article outline, and I could have it write an article based off of that outline. So these prompts will work on any text, but I think by far the best use case is to use them with the voice transcriber, because the voice transcriber is just going to spit out a big block of text that you're then going to want to format. And even something like the article outline, the use case that I use more often with that is that I'm actually going to just sort of ramble a voice note about my article, and then I'm going to transform that into an article outline. So to be honest, I would say 8 or 9 times out of 10, whenever I'm using the AI assistant, it's on some sort of voice note, but I do take a lot of voice notes. Okay, so that's the first section here. Now, number two here, creating custom prompts. So maybe all of those examples, except for one, these were all using custom prompts. So if I go back to this call transcript, and let me go back and run my project proposal prompt here. So this is going to run, and we can ignore that, but let me go up and expand this here. So you can take any prompt and expand it, and you're going to see what exactly it's being asked to do. So here it's quite generic. I just ask it to put it into a project proposal, and I sort of describe what the project proposal is. So it's going to take the input text, which is anything that's highlighted, and do this to it. Let me see if I have a better one, maybe like my content and social project proposal. Yeah, this is a better one. I'm going to have it stop that there. So if I expand this one, this is probably a better use case because here I've instructed it what to do, but I've also included a format for the project proposal. And so here it has a markdown kind of format that it's going to put the project proposal into. And it's going to have variables and things like that that I can fill in or that it can figure out how to fill in. And this is really nice because then you're going to get a really consistent format. So it works really well for things like project proposals where you know what format you want the file project proposal to be in. Now, there's a bunch of built-in prompts, and that's actually how you can create a custom one. So all these prompts at the top here, it says custom. These are all custom ones I've made. But if I keep scrolling down here, you're going to eventually see system. These are all the system prompts that are included with the AI assistant just right out of the box. So if I was doing something like, a project proposal, it's like I could take something like a short summary. It's going to run there, but let me just expand it. And then I can click clone. And once you've cloned a system prompt, you're free to edit it however you would like. So I can now call this project proposal. Maybe this one will be specific to LinkedIn just so I give it a different name. And I can go in here and start editing anything. And so, you know, I can edit the simple instructions. I can go put a, proposal format down there, but that's pretty much it. And then once you're done editing, you click save and you now have a custom prompt. I do think the easiest way to do a custom prompt, well, I have a couple tips there. I'm not going to save that. The first tip is to, if you're doing something like a project proposal or a daily reflection, first start by writing the actual format in a note. So if I go to that daily reflection note, not a daily note. You can see here that I have my format here on top. So I've got three things for gratitude, a reframing exercise, and a top priority. The easiest way to actually get the AI prompt to format this would just be to copy it and then paste it into that custom prompt. So this one is already existing, but if this wasn't here, or maybe I wanted to redo how this format was done, I could just highlight this and paste everything in there, and it will pretty well know how to format that. You might have to tweak it a little bit, so maybe run it once or twice, but once you have the format nailed, it's really, really nice to just run these quickly. Okay, cool. And then I guess the last tip I have for that one, if you need to, you can convert things to Markdown using ChatGPT or other AI. It's really, really good at that. And it helps if you choose the original prompt that's the closest to the new one you want. So, for something like if you wanted to make a meeting assistant, you would probably want to start with one that says list key takeaways. And then you can kind of just build on it from there. It makes that easier. Okay, cool. So that's creating custom prompts. And then using the open prompt field. So I could also do something where I just highlight this, pull up the AI assistant. I just use Command J there again. And you can see there's an open field text box. So I could just say, can you take this text and turn it into a one pager for a client? Now, this is useful in some cases. In this case, I would want to save this as a custom prompt because you're not really going to want know exactly what the output is here. And so if I want to now tweak this lightly, I'm going to have to insert it and tweak it because if I just close out of the AI system, it's not going to remember it. But it can be nice if you just have one-off requests that you want to ask text about. You can use that open field text box. So that does exist as an option. Lastly, for this AI assistant, before I go on to chatting with your notes with AI, you can go into preferences and tweak the models you use, and you can also access unlimited AI prompting by adding your own API keys. So if I go to my preferences page here, you see here that you can choose, an AI provider. So by default, it's set to Anthropic, which uses Claude. You can also change it to OpenAI, which will use GPT. And we always keep those updated based on what is the most effective, and the available model. And you have a set amount of tokens that you can use. You can find out exactly what those are at reflect.academy/artificial intelligence. Or if you just go to reflect.academy, you'll find the tab there. But you can put in your own OpenAI API keys in any of these fields. You will need to set up a billing account with a provider, but that basically lets them bill you for your AI usage. And it's really, really cheap. I've never heard of anyone going more than like a dollar or two a day on their AI usage, even if they're obsessive users. But, you know, we have many users. So if for us, if we actually did for a while allow unlimited use of the AI feature and it got abused. So we had to put limits on it. But if you want to bypass those limits, you can put your API key in there. There's also some settings with the transcription here. I talked about that last week. But I think the big ones here are the AI provider and the AI keys. Cool. So this brings us to the last category, chatting with your notes. So this is done through our advanced search. If I pull up the advanced search here, I can either search for something or add filters, and that will narrow down the context window so that the AI chat has context from my notes to pull on, because the AI system does not have access to your entire notes. So if I select tag here, and then I select book, and then chat with my notes, I'm now effectively chatting with my own digital library. So I can ask it, what kinds of books do I like to read? And it will use the notes that I have filtered there for context. And so it's going to probably, yeah, put a couple categories there and it will list the examples. That seems pretty spot on. And then I can, because it's a chat, I can keep asking follow-up. So maybe now I want to say, can you please make some recommendations for a next book to read? And here it's got some books that it's recommending to me. Those seem pretty good. I haven't read those yet. I think Life of Pi I did when I was younger. But so it's taking each of the categories and it's now recommending books based off of what I already read. Now, our AI chat uses Google Gemini, which allows it to take in an extremely large number of notes for context. And that means that I could even say daily notes in the past, I'll say past 1 year. Sounds good. And then chat with those. And I can say, summarize the kinds of work I've been doing in the last year. And it's going to look at all of my daily notes over the past year and come out with the main categories. And remember that this is an AI assistant. This is not data scraping. So you're not going to be able to scrape every little last thing of your work in your daily notes, but it's good for pulling out concepts and themes. Think of it like a person. If you just kind of ask them something off the top of their head, they're not going to be able to, just kind of comb through everything, but they'll be able to tell you, general summaries, pull on it for research. So sometimes I have people that will come back and say, I asked the AI chat what the 17th word in this note was, and it didn't know. Yeah, it's not going to know that. But if you ask it to summarize the note or repurpose it into something else, it'll do a pretty good job with that. Okay, and then I guess the one other thing to mention that we've now added is that there is a persistent search. So that if you come back here, search for, travel. Yeah, this is a fake graph, so I don't have a ton of notes on travel. But if I make that search and then I close out of the chat and come back to it, that search now stays there. So I can kind of work with my notes in between using it. And if I do want to reset, I can use this reset button. And there we go. It goes back to this kind of filter based off of just the notes I've been using recently. Did I miss any examples? Chat with your library, get insights. Yep, I did those. So there's a lot of different things you can do with that. You can chat with your recipe book if you have a recipe tag. I do think using the tag filter is one of my favorite ways to chat with different categories of notes here, but you can see all of these different search types. I don't have a specific video in this onboarding flow about our advanced search because it's pretty self-explanatory apart from that chat feature, but you can go add any of these filters, anything, and you can also change the search type. So you can do fuzzy, you can do exact, or you can do semantic so that you don't have to remember the exact phrases. Lastly, just to talk about device compatibility for those AI features, the AI Assistant is available on the iPhone iOS app. It works just the same as it does on your desktop computer. So if I go tap into this line item, I can double tap on it and click the exact same stars icon in the menu there, and it pulls up the exact same AI Assistant. So this is the same one that's on the desktop app. Any custom prompts that you save on desktop will also work here and vice versa. And yeah, I can just tap on one. Maybe I'll generate an email for this line item. It'll be kind of a weird result since it's a fake example, but there you go. You see the prompt runs in the exact same way. And once it's done running, I have the same options to replace it there if I want to. And there we go. Now, the AI chat with your notes is not available on the iPhone app because we do not have our advanced search on the iPhone app yet. I think that might be coming at some point in the future. Both are available on the iPad app, however, both the AI chat with your notes and the AI assistant that I just showed you. So go play with it across your devices. It's really, really helpful. Again, use it with the voice transcriber, which is also available on the mobile apps.